clear that we need to state categorically that nothing has been decided yet.
No.
And if we say that 10 times, maybe people will understand.
We hope so.
Okay.
Some won't get it 50.
Yeah.
Right. It is what it is.
Yeah, well, it is what it is.
So the facts are the facts.
Yeah.
Right. So you just stay with those.
Yeah.
We're all right.
Yeah, Corey, I think what's going to happen is council, if they don't, why, you know, because basically these are, you know, impact studies, economic impact studies, basically is what we did, is that, and if council, you know, decides that they want to look at maybe a three-story or whatever, they would make a recommendation to come back to CIC. It is ultimately all about city council.
And that's why Kelly and I tried to make it so factual, and we even referenced that we put out statement of qualifications, that we have received these statements. We really, there's very few items in the process that has taken place since this was basically declared council rule that is not at some point in time spelled out in this process. There's nothing else left, so it's a very factual thing. So, you know, we did do two SOQs.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing we probably missed is, we did do a full survey of the property.
Should we include information on that, what the property appraised for? That probably...
The two items that, now that I'm sitting here telling you we didn't forget anything, I'm thinking about two items that are part of what we did was, A, we secured a professional appraisal of the property.
Right.
Yeah.
And B, we secured a full physical survey of the property. And part of that is just things that were going to be needed no matter what. So, I think that those are two items that I did both of those that it sure doesn't hurt if you're just doing full transparency to throw those in there. The survey.
Okay. I agree. I think that would be.
We had Miguel Smith do a full blown corner to corner marker survey.
Mm-hmm. This has been a very diligent process, and once again, you know, as far as why the information is out there, that, you know, everything was already decided is just factually inaccurate.
Well, I think our charge was to take 100 choices down to a manageable level,
right,
which is what we've done.
Right.
Correct.
Exactly.
Do you feel there's anything that we've learned through this process or that we need to include in this memo?
Who's going to receive this memo?
It'll be in the council packet.
Yeah, it'll be a matter of public record. Right?
So, you know, everybody uses a TIF. I'm not sure the general public understands what a TIF is and how it works. So there's always this suspicion out there that we're spending taxpayers' money. It might help to just put another couple sentences of what a TIF is and how it impacts a homeowner or a citizen, because everybody thinks this is free money, but it comes from somewhere.
Right.
So you might as well identify so there's not that concern that the city leaders are spending money, you know, without thought or without pursuing, you know, all the best options.
Okay.
So a little bit of education always helps calm and
absolutely
focus on the facts.
Yeah.
Include in there that it's not something that homeowners are going to see an increase in their taxes, and just talk about how TIFs are basically only on the public improvements of those properties.
Just
it doesn't increase property taxes or anything like that.
Okay.
And give a little education.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have a chance to educate. You can do it in three or four sentences.
Yeah.
Do it.
That's a great suggestion, too, for our FAQ sheet.
That's the hard part, but absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
I mean,
that's
a
great suggestion.
Might as well give an education of where that is and why are we using that tool versus something else.
And if you notice that when we wrote this, we purposely avoided things like design elements, road elements, because we're not trying to sell it. So those items are purposely left. Who's where? Who's going here? What this? What are we doing? Those parts are purposely out because they haven't been decided.
Right.
So we sort of stopped ourselves from doing that, and that's what lends us, which is why the few items we just decided we want to add stay exactly with what our sort of call was amongst her out, but Kelly and I, when we were writing this.
Going back to what we were talking about in the beginning regarding the recommendation, Pam, I think you made a good point stating statutory requirements. Should we add that in regarding the public hearings?
Probably. I don't know. What do you guys think? I mean,
I think the more information that you put in there, make it as concise as you can, because you can make this document 20 pages long if you want to. Make it short and sweet, but just to say we've done our due diligence, we've followed the law, we've exposed whatever we need to expose. Yeah, if there are codes that have to be noted so that somebody might want to look them up, I would include those if they're pertinent. Because I think what we're really trying to do here is, as best we can, eliminate or answer questions that people would have right off the bat. And if we can do that in 4 pages, that's an accomplishment.
Okay, so from what I've heard, we're going to add appraisal and survey of property information, add the composition of the CIC board, add TIF education, and
any codes regarding statutory needs or public hearings.
Right. We actually want the ORC sections referenced, because then it gets muddy. There's all different,
you're right,
they reference different sections. I mean, TIF law, there's various different codes depending on.
Is it just as easy to say that all this is public information and it can be found someplace, or
we'll wordsmith it.
Yeah.
Meet statutory requirements of the Ohio Revised
Code.
Right.
That should,
and then just cite the
that
code.
Should
that should do it. Because then if you really want to get into the nitty gritty, you can just pull it.
Yeah, stick it to readers digest.
Yeah, I was gonna say, yeah.
Well, you can keyword search the Ohio Revised Code as well. I think most of Chapter 7 governs a lot of municipality requirements, but then I think it's Chapter 54 or something that all the TIF stuff is under, so.
You know what I think would be key? You've got this draft in 4 pages. If you can keep it at 4 pages.
Yeah.
Okay.
That
would
be that.
Yeah.
I don't think that's a problem.
It should
be too much of a problem.
Okay. To work on adding that information in there and get this resent for your review. If no one has any other additional items,
today, probably by noon tomorrow, we'll have it wrapped up. So what I have to write is just a survey, and the appraisal is going to take 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. It's going to pull the data out, the cost of it, what we ended up with, and then Kelly and I sort of pass it back and forth, I'm sure. And then we'll get it out to you.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah. So, and just so everyone here who, so they understand, for our visitors here, that this memo will be public record when it is sent to the council packet. It will be in the council packet, which will be a matter of public record. Is that right?
That would be more of a chair question.
Okay, it's I'm right. I think I'm right.
I'm right?
Yeah. Okay.
I was under the impression it's already public record, but I don't know.
Okay. No, I mean it is, but the formal memorandum when it's completed for everyone who wants to read it ahead of time before Tuesday, it will be on the website and it will be part of the council packet. That's what I mean.
Correct.
You'll have plenty of days to be able to read it before the actual council meaning.
Yes.
That's what I meant. Didn't say it right, sorry.
Can I ask a question about this deck that was prepared? Is this what's going to be presented to the council?
To be included in the packet?
But it's not going to run through.
No, he's not going through it.
Ken did what you guys
yeah.
requested
yeah.
Ken to do, and he got it back to us early in the week. We then began, that's when we started.
Okay.
And that's why, because he did well in the packet, because we were still working on it until we felt we had something solid enough to give to you.
Well, we got the information yesterday.
Yeah.
So,
okay. We jumped right on it. But I'm just saying we're really
done. We should get word of death by PowerPoint.
Yeah.
No.
I think that was I will not be at the meeting on Tuesday. But now we do have our next regularly scheduled meeting.
Yes,
May 15th at 3:10.
And
neither of us will be
here. One of us will be there.
But everyone else.
You'll have a quorum.
Okay,
thank you. Okay, thanks. Yes, we need to make a motion to adjourn.
I will make a motion to adjourn at 2:04, 2:05.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, thanks, guys. This is good.